on Wednesday. She too will be familiar with how to approach the game. Yeah. Rumpan, rumpan. And she continues to. TAI Tzu Ying also knows that the drift is moving left to right.
Fault.
Yeah, you can see in her technique, like how the kind of touch she has in where she places.
TAI Tzu Ying to get, try and get the shuttle behind her.
Stretching her out to find the gaps and the openings.
Yeah, big smash. Of course in 2018, where she lost to her opponent in front of her. To resume the second game.
Stuff, and then she's just not finding her lines there. Like a few unforced errors go down.
Great. TAI Tzu Ying.
Yeah.
Given the error she made. Nope.
I think she waited a bit too long, so it got too low.
Even Chichu. It's TAI Tzu Ying. Nice angle. She just tilted. Just running 1-5 of the last 6 points.
14, 13. That one looked like it could be out as well.
Oh, what a net. catch up. Still going. Ah, she missed that. In good stead. Okay. Oh, beautifully. Gone wide, and Tzu Ying respond early will be key. Finals in 2019, and that's when she lost to Nozomi Okuhara. Till this year. She becomes all that much harder to beat. Look at that shot. That. Last year, she played all four quarterfinals at the Super 1000 tournaments. Was unwell. Nice. Nice shot again.
Yeah, she rules the kingdom of badminton.
Hey.
Back. Yeah, well left. Long. And again now, four or five errors in a row in the second game. First game, she's got a foot in the door. As Tzu Ying continue now, Grania. But I am surprised that she's not hitting like those faster downward shots, in case since she's struggling with the loopy forehand so much.
Yeah. She could definitely start just playing stuff down and seeing those lifts and clears all the shots that are, she's hitting out the back more.
Yeah. in the second game. It's been TAI Tzu Ying who's
couldn't flick of her fingers to just redirect it straight.
Difficult, a big mountain to climb. Rushed shots.
Fault.
So on the third match point opportunity, TAI Tzu Ying closes out and